Hello there, good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and joining us today from Kodal Minerals, we have Bernard Aylward. Hello to you, Bernard.
Hello, Katie.
So today we're going to be discussing this gold project in southern Mali, Fatou. Can you maybe explain why you wanted this so much?
Well, we think it's a great opportunity for our shareholders immediately, Katie. It's an advanced exploration play. It's immediately compatible with our existing projects. And most importantly, you'll be aware that West Africa is a well-known region for gold mineralization. This project is immediately in the district of major mines such as Morila, Soyama, Tongon in Cote d'Ivoire just to the south of us, Sissingué to the south of us, and for UK investors, the Hummingbird mine at Yanfolila is also close to us to the west, and we think it represents a great opportunity. Adds value to our existing gold portfolio that we've maintained for a long time.
Excellent. So you're saying that it's immediately compatible?
Yep. We have a team that's experienced in this region. We have a team that's worked in close proximity to this project. We have the data. We understand the exploration required. We understand the region. I think it's immediately compatible. Our team has been to visit site already. And we've developed a program that we think will confirm the previous work and then move to expand that.
Excellent. So you've mentioned some of the mines that it's nearby. Maybe just give us an example of somewhere where you're hoping to possibly replicate or even do better than.
Well, I think, an easy example to discuss is our joint venture in Cote d'Ivoire with Resolute Mining. Back in 2016, a joint venture commenced. Resolute have undertaken exploration on projects that were at that stage, very early stage. We think they've made a discovery in northern Cote d'Ivoire at Nile. We're hoping that they will continue that work and possibly define a resource. I compare that to what we've acquired at Fatou, and I look at a project that we've picked up now with a previous history of exploration. We've acquired that database, we've acquired that early stage work, and we've got something that we can build on. And I think we'll be able to demonstrate a significant resource quite quickly, building from what is starting off at a 350,000 ounce, 43-101 compliant resource.
And what are you exactly hoping to achieve there at Fatou?
Overall, our focus as a company is long-term, we believe that the lithium market will underpin our development. We look at our Bougouni lithium project as representing the opportunity for a first mine development for the company. Mm-hmm. Secondly, we look at our gold assets and say there's a chance to realize immediate value through our first step, acquiring the advanced project, demonstrating the potential of that project, and then looking to crystallize value, whether that value is through an ongoing joint venture with the funding partners or through a mechanism to create a monetizing event, and whether that monetizing event is a sale, an IPO, or a vend to another company. We're happy to look at all opportunities, but immediately we see that we have a lot to offer in terms of improving that value.
And while we're talking about funding and crystallising value, if you like, maybe talk us through the financials on this deal.
Yeah, look, we think we've actually done a great deal for our shareholders. We've been able to secure funding of $2.5 million. That money is particularly focused on gold development. That money will be used to complete the acquisition of the projects, to fund the drilling of the projects, to fund the expansion of those projects. That money is coming in at a project level, not at a PLC level. It doesn't give a dilution to our existing shareholders and in fact exposes our shareholders to assets that we currently don't have and to upside that we think we'll be able to demonstrate through drilling. So yes, it's immediately non-dilutionary. And when we come to crystallize value, we expect to be able to show that we've significantly improved the value of all of our gold assets.
So when is the drilling starting here?
We anticipate in January, Katie. We've planned. We've had our team, as I said, out to site already. We actually have our crew out at the moment at our Dabakala project in Cote d'Ivoire. And just to give you that sort of discussion on what our comparison is, Dabakala is a project I really like, but it's quite early stage. We're highlighting a new surface geochemical anomaly. We're infilling and looking to define that anomaly in preparation for drilling. And then we compare that to Fatou, where we are now able to move into an area where a resource has been defined. And I think we're giving a great opportunity for discovery, for expansion over a range of projects. And so we are active explorers, and we're looking to continue that with drilling in January.
Excellent. So do come back in January and tell us about some of these drilling results then, please, Bernard. Just one last thing as well, in terms of, you mentioned lithium there. So in terms of long-term, your lithium project, is that your main focus then, would you say?
Yes, I do say that. And I reiterate that I think that lithium is a major mineral for the future, that we're seeing a lot of focus on electric vehicles, on green energy storage, on development of improved technologies, and lithium is going to be a major part of that. For us, we look at our Bougouni lithium project. We have a defined resource. We've got a mining license application in with the Mali government. We're expecting that to be granted shortly. However, as we're all aware, 2020 has been a very unusual year. Impact of COVID in Mali, impact of government changes and restrictions. But we're looking that 2021 will be a much improved year for us. And I'd like to highlight that with our lithium and as our company, that we have our major shareholder, our offtake partner, and our MOU with Sinohydro is advancing quickly. So we are looking to move to the development of Bougouni, and we think long-term that lithium mine will underpin all future growth of Kodal.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. Kodal Minerals, Bernard Aylward here on Proactive London today.
Thank you, Katie.